My name is the Prime Engine, and I get asked this question all the time. How do you go from VS Code to Vim? I just don't understand it. I'm confused. I'm lost. I'm scared. I need my file tree. Just calm down. Just calm down. All right? Vim has all these things, and I'm going to take you through the very simple process of going from an IDE to just Vim. It's actually incredibly simple. It's quick and it's straightforward. So let's get after it. Let's drop that IDE, baby. All right, so to drop an IDE and go straight into Vim, you only need to do two simple things. Two steps to learn Vim? It took me 900 to do Emacs. There's no way this video's real. One, the first thing you need to do is get the Vim plugin. The Vim plugin is essential because first you need to be able to just learn a couple Vim moves, and honestly, you can just jump right in to using Vim. It's honestly that simple. Two, just a couple quick commands you need to learn to be able to be proficient at Vim, and then you can make that jump from VS Code to Vim. So let's talk about that. First, you need to know J and K, H and L. Then you're gonna need to know W, B, E. Then don't forget F and T and capital F, and of course, capital T. Then you're going to need to know YY, P, DD, and of course, Shift P. Never sleep on the Shift P. Quite useful. Sometimes you need to delete by character or insert mode delete by character or the entire line. Just very important things to know about. Sometimes you find yourself on squirrely braces in which you need to jump. Use that percent sign, and of course, that pesky capitalized character, hit it with a tilde. Sometimes you need to go to the back of the line. Sometimes you need to go to the front of the line. Sometimes you need to go to the very beginning or in certain mode needed at the beginning or end of the line. Very straightforward. So now you are ready to learn some more Vim. I'm specifically talking about ins and outs. We're talking, of course, about the DI. Do not forget about the CI, of course, the YI, and of course, the VI. And then you can paste in your YI results. You got your equal I for quick fix. And of course, don't forget about your DA, your CA, your YA, and then of course your VA, which a quick paste, and then you can fix everything up with an equal A. Now you are ready for one last quick command. Well, of course, we're talking about G. So I'm gonna just type the letter foo here and shift highlight right there. Now I'm gonna press GI to jump to my last insert or GV to jump to my last highlight, GQ to adjust that really long and atrocious long comment. Right after that, I need to open up some windows. So I do a little control WV to do a vertical split, a little control WS to do a horizontal split. I like to think of a sunset on the horizon. Reminds me of horizontal. A little EX to open up that file explorer, a little control WL to jump one way, H to jump the other way, J to jump one way, and K to jump the other way, and of course, control W, shift O to close all of them down. And of course, there's one last thing you really need to know. When you want to exit Vim, it's just a quick shutdown now, and boom, you are done. Well, color me unsurprised. Sticking with Emacs. My name is the Prime Engine. Thank you so much for watching. If you haven't caught on, there may have been a bit of satire within this video. I don't know if you spotted it, but I'm sure if you watch it close enough, you just might find it. Go ahead, look down below. Look at all the angry comments, and I bet you this will be my most angry video with people being like, VS Code's really nice. You don't know what you're talking about. I really like it. It just makes me feel so safe and warm inside. I don't care. Get oiled up, slide in, and enjoy that sweet, sweet Vim experience. Ah, shoot. Ah, shoot. Oh, my goodness. Dogs. Be quiet, dogs. Stop pressing one! Stop! Dude, my brain, I cannot speak and do it at the same time.